Hey everyone, Liam from AdButler again with another tutorial video, and today we're going to be doing something a bit different. We're going to step outside of AdButler and look at WordPress today. Specifically, how to use both together and get AdButler running on WordPress. WordPress is that great piece of software that today's modern internet is basically built on. Thousands of websites, including our own blog, blog.adbutler.com, run on it. Our plugin for WordPress allows you to place and configure an AdButler zone in any widget on your website and simplifies the process. Setting it up is really easy, and I'm going to run through it right now with you. A quick note before I start, you will need to access your AdButler admin account. That's the account above all other accounts, the one with all the billing information and everything tied to it. So if you're just a user account, once you hit the point where you need to access the admin account, you might need to ask for access to it. Now this video is only going to go over how to install the plugin and set up a zone. We'll go over the more advanced features in another video. To start, open up your WordPress dashboard and head over to plugins. Please note right now that if your website is hosted on WordPress.com, you won't be able to use our plugin because you cannot use any plugins on WordPress.com. Moving past that, click on the Add New button and search AdButler. You're looking for the one by Sparklet Networks, that's us, and you want to hit the Install Now button. The plugin will quickly get downloaded and we can click Activate to get it running. If we move over to the installed plugins list, the AdButler plugin will now be listed here, and we can click Settings to start linking it to our account. We'll be greeted by a prompt asking for our AdButler key. For this, we'll need to log into that admin account in AdButler. Once you log into your AdButler dashboard, we're looking for the Settings option in the top left. In here, we'll find a completely unreadable string called WordPress key. We'll need to copy this entire string and paste it into the prompt on our WordPress website and hit Save. We'll then get a confirmation and be good to go. The rest of this screen goes over the basic usage of the plugin, so feel free to read it. Now that our WordPress and AdButler accounts are linked, I can head over to Appearances, Widget Area, and place the widget wherever I want my banner to appear. You'll notice that the list of zones is categorized under Publisher, and if I head back into AdButler, all my zones and publishers are present in the same tiers. Heading back to WordPress, I can select which zone I want and what kind of tag I want placed. We always recommend async, but feel free to use whatever. If you're looking for explanations on the different tags, you can find them here. You can also set if you want the zones to serve over SSL or if you want to pass extra click data along with the banner. Finally, hit Save and the zone is good to go, confirmed by this Add Properly Configured message. I can now head back to my WordPress site and, look at that, our banner has now shown up. If I click it, we'll track the click, an impression will go, and everything is pretty much working without having to make any changes to the website's code. So that is the basic implementation of our WordPress plugin. We do have some higher level functionality, as I said earlier, which I'll be going over on our next video. As always, feel free to leave a comment with any questions or email us to get in touch. Also, if you are looking for videos on anything specific, leave a comment and/or email us your suggestion. Once again, this was Liam from AdButler. Thanks for watching, guys, and have a good day.